Today, we are going to talk about a technique that is going to facilitate the creation of our color palettes, hue shifting. But before that, I have to talk a bit about local colors. The local color of an object is the color that we perceive whenever we see it up close, lit by a white light. This is what we could consider as the real color or the central color of an object. In the real world, light doesn't hit entities uniformly, so the local color gives us a base from which we can derive shadow tones and light tones. Often, we create color palettes from the local colors that are going to dominate our paintings. What is hue shifting then? Without a doubt, it's one of the most common techniques when it comes to creating color palettes for game assets. It is simple. We start with the object's local color, for instance our main character's blue coat. To find the corresponding shadow tone, we are naturally going to sample the coat's local color and lower its brightness. The hue shifting techniques invites you to also move its hue in a given direction. This technique simplifies the process of creating a palette as it gives us a concrete method to follow in order to derive harmonious new tones from our main colors. But you may ask, in which direction should we shift hues on the ribbon, and to what extent? Well, it depends. If you analyze a photo or a painting, you will notice that each of the three HSL values of colors move quite a bit from one zone of the picture to another. And often, it does so in an unpredictable pattern. However, in many cases, you can see a progression of hues in a specific direction. This is the case with skies, for example, with which you can see gradients from blue to yellow to red and even to purple at dusk. It is critical to take the time to observe and analyze pictures to get a good hang of hue shifting. For each new subject that you are going to study, I invite you to download a few reference images on a website like Pinterest and to take notes on the behavior of colors. If the hue shifting technique is often raised as a form of principle, by pixel artists in particular, it is due to the fact that, on a computer, a beginner will have a tendency to neglect the richness of the hues we can find on any given object. The tiniest blade of grass can contain shades of green, of yellow, of turquoise, and even of purple, why not? The colors we find in our environment are the result of complex interactions between light and objects. No technique can actually make up for the long hours of study required to understand its behavior. If techniques are handy, they are but tools. They are the catalyst of your knowledge, of your sense of light and color in that case. Thus, if we get used to playing with the hue of our colors, we can then get better at analyzing what we see in nature. Actually, you shouldn't neglect any of the three HSL components we have talked about in the previous How to Game Art. But with hue shifting, you can first focus on the brightness of the color, then change its hue, and play again with its brightness and saturation afterwards. With practice, it becomes mechanical. You can then forget it altogether and only think about the colors. You can not only use the color picker, but also the hue saturation tool to shift hues and extend your palette. As this tool gives you a slider for each of the three HSL channels, it permits you to better control your color changes. However, be careful with one thing. On Photoshop, the lightness slider doesn't work the same way the brightness value does in the color picker. This option actually pulls your color towards white or black. It doesn't just brighten your color, but it also affects its saturation. That's it for today. If you like the video and want to see more, don't hesitate to become a subscriber. That way, you'll be notified whenever I release a new tutorial or start streaming. Thank you for watching.